Hello friends, welcome back to CLTD Pro Tips and Tricks YouTube channel. In this video, I will show you how to create surface from the points. So for that, what you need is to have either Excel file or a text file with the data of point number, northing, easting, elevation and point description. So if you have those data of the point, you can create surface out of those points. So either you have a .csv file space delimited or comma delimited. Same way, either you have a file space delimited or comma or point. So here I have both. So let's see how you can import those into CL3D first. So what you need to go to the points, create points, and the dialog wall will open. Just click from here and go to this plus icon and select your file. Sorry. Then you need to select the correct format which your data is, whether it's point northing easting or point easting northing, whether there is an elevation or a description on it's not. So my data is PNEZD space delimited. Click OK. So here it is. Now I have to create surface out of it, and let's see how create. First, let's see the data. So if you can see that my data, if I go to the Excel file, that I have ground point, pond point and different kind of points, but I don't want to create my surface out of all the points. I want to create my surface only ground points or the road point or the curve point. So let's see how we create those once we have got all the data in. So what you need to do is create a point group. So I right click and create new, and I give this point group to my ground level. Now what you need to do is you need to have a correct raw description. So if I go in my data, I can see that my description of ground is GRND. So you have to write with the raw description and just write here GRND. So you have to write the correct description name and star. So I'm putting star over here because what happened, there is a description like ground, then some points, some description. So what it take, whatever the name start with the ground, it takes all the points. So if you have a name of the ground, topo point, ground, this point, so it will take all this ground points into this. So that's why you have to keep that star. So just click OK, and I'll just give some point style to it. Point L is a description. Click apply and OK. So you can see now what I'll do, I go to here and I close all this point. So you can see now just my ground point is visible over here. So I created this. I can turn off this point from here. If I don't want to show this, I just click turn off the style. Okay, now I go to the surface, create surface, select my existing ground point, click OK. Now here expand this, go to the definition, and now here you have option of point group. So go to this, add, and select your ground level point. Click apply and see. So in this way you can only create surface out of the point you want if you have a correct description. So if I have to add more points, like I have a in my Excel sheet, let's see, curve points or And he wrote poems. So I will take only those things. So if I see the correct description of my PowerPoint, CRUB B and CRUB F. So I can take those both into it. So I create another group. Go to new. And I will say curve points. And here include, I'll go with the description exactly what I can do, just copy from here. So you need to have an exact description. So just click this. Okay. And this star again. Go to your Excel. Click this. Select this. And control Z. Give the star. And apply. If you want to see the pointers, apply styles. Okay, so you can see all my curve points now. And you can enter this point group, click add, and you can see here, and you can add. So you can see that my surface has bit changed at the ground point. So in this way, you can create your surface based on whatever the points you want, based on the descriptions, and you can create group out of point, and means from all those you can distinguish and you can take whatever you want, or you can delete. Also you can set up different style for it. So if I want to set up this into different style, I can do it. I can anytime show it or hide this point, or if I want to just elevation only, just give it. So you can control your point how you want particular point to show. If you want to show the point in a different color or a different style, you can show this. So you can distinguish between the different kind of point, whether your curve point or ground point, with the help of this point group. So this is one method of creating point groups. There are other methods also creating from point groups that we are going to see in the next video. Because you have so many options here, you can create point groups with the number, or with the elevation matching, with the name matching, with the full descriptions. Also you can create a description key. So if you want to exclude some point out of this, means I have all the data and just I want to include particular point, you can do that. So there are so many options that you've given, include and exclude. In this way you can create your points. And again you can export this. So if I want to export only my curve data out of my all the data, so I can create my point group and just export my curve data into it. So if you want to export particular data, you can create point group and then export those only. So you just go to export, select your current correct format, go desktop and select my curve point. Click open and you can see it's my curve point. And okay, now go to here. If you can see the text file, that all my curve points are here. So if you want to export particular points, you can do it by this.